I cannot lose weight here, I tell you. Women always take care. They always want more of me. That doesn't work with sleepy. Sleepy hippie is the worst you can find.
Big guy, big guy, does more.
Oh, heavy work. But yesterday was fun, no?
Yeah.
The wind, and what happened, I said something will happen today. What happened in Paris, you thought?
Yeah.
Wow. It was really in the air. Wow. 150 dead or something.
What happened?
Huh?
What happened?
Ja, you should. Nur Internet. Ja, but you should look at the news and not at Facebook. Everyone is missing a lot. Face of my enemy, that's Facebook.
So what happened?
What?
What happened?
Like last year or the year before, this shooting from this against this magazine, and then now they took a cinema or theater.
No, it was an American rock concert.
Or something like that. Yeah, but it was in a theater. It was.
Yeah.
There was a German-French test game for football, so they chose the right day.
Full
of Germans.
I think four different places.
Huh?
Four different places.
Four different places. They could not be. The world is under attack. So from the relative point of view, it's quite something. And the other one, something has fun. Or someone has fun. But, not what? That the girls sit together, you cannot keep them quiet. Girls they're building just a new company. Girls just want to have fun. Unlimited. LTD. Always when I see that, I think I have to behave like one. It's like filtering my tongue or something. Speak beautiful. Speak some beauty should come out. Like devil. Temptation of the flowers. That's called flower power. So, then you can start. Carlos, huh?
Yeah. Half asleep.
You slept well?
No, I didn't sleep.
Ah, I see.
He's half asleep.
Half asleep.
Half asleep?
Yeah.
He's still half asleep.
Half awake, half asleep.
Oh, yes. He's neither here or not here. It's a stay there because it's the undecided state. I don't know if I'm here or not. It's like Twilight Zone. That's the best. You just enter Twilight Zone. You don't know if you're light or not light or anything. If it's dark or light or sounds good. Okay, how is it in the twilight?
Well, it feels good. It feels good. How you doing?
Quite relaxing, huh?
Quite
relaxing.
It's very relaxing. Yeah. But the mind is now very sharp.
What? Something coming out of that sharp sword. I cannot get it out anymore.
Right. Oh, yeah.
I'm a peaceful warrior now. I put it so deep into the... I cannot get it out anymore, even if I try. That's why people complain now, I am too soft, because it doesn't fucking get it out anymore, even if I want.
It's interesting because this morning I talked to my friend that yesterday when you mentioned about tapas, and then I remind you that tapas was something that Guruji was teasing me all the time with tapas. So, and then thinking afterwards, it came to my mind that yesterday was the Mahasamadhi of Guruji.
Ah, so talking about him then.
Yeah. Right, Mahasamadhi.
So I'm quite in tune.
Yeah.
Forget it, it's not for you. It's that already, come on, forget it. What already? The Germans, just to make a history out of... They just want to put you in a box. Oh, he comes from that... Well, I'm saying they're just concentration camp guys. They want to concentrate on... They put you in a concentration camp and then the gas comes.
Tomorrow Maharaj.
Maharaj?
The girls, Mahasamadhi.
From who?
Mahasamadhi. Rajiv Maharaj is Mahasamadhi tomorrow.
Oh, every day is something. Especially the one who didn't die, it's even worse. Celebration of birthdays and that one. And your birthday comes soon or something. You're fucked by birthdays. And dead days. That's why they call it daddy. You come out of a dead guy. It's a daddy. So what is? What else?
Nothing. And then came Guruji, and then you mentioned what is your Guruji name, and I said very fast you didn't pick up the name. Mari was saying something, so then the conversation went.
So the name went out of...
Yeah, the name went out.
Into so, the ether.
Yes, it happened to the air. So I thought it could be nice maybe to give you an introduction to Guruji. So I bought some books, maybe...
I don't read.
So. You don't read?
No.
You like it to help?
No. So not be around. show me a
picture.
Then I know everything. Serious. Babuji. Okay. Farewell. Okay. No, talking about tapas. We talked about tapas. What you think is the highest tapa you can do? After. Now you are expert now. You had one who told you all about tapas.
Yeah.
And now I'm asking you what is your highest tapa and you are...
I am afraid that I'm going to fail the exam.
You will fail anyway.
Yeah.
That's not the point. Don't be afraid to fail. You're here to be fearless. Not fearing to fail. That's fearlessness. Just enjoying the failing you're here for, not for... maybe I could say something wrong. If I would sit here and would be afraid to say something wrong, I could not open my mouth anymore. It's all wrong anyway. So what is the highest of us? Accordingly to that guy. Whoever that is. Because he didn't even know what he is, who he is. So. What did Teddy say? Yeah, yeah.
Self-avoidance.
You're just a Vincham.
Summer in Tiruvannamalai. Summertime in Tiruvannamalai. Brahmana said that's one of the highest tapas you can do.
Was that sadhana?
That is sadhana. You're right. Sadhana.
That is sadhana. Yeah. That's not tapas.
You're right.
That is just being sad and hot.
Yeah.
That's called a sad ananda. So when your ananda is very sad and hot. No, tapas are exercises. What is this called? Meditation or what type of exercise? No, I am asking something, and you see what comes out? So what? What do you think? Should I wait? Well, should I? Because my name is Carlos too, so I can. Any one Carlos will answer. No, did you read books of him?
Yeah,
but then it's, in every book is pointers of that. Yeah. So everyone reads the books, but going through the wind. No, this is tapa. This is the highest tapa. Ramana said, good company. So there's one who's talking without a talker, and so you enter the listening without a listener, which is meditation. Action without expectation. Action without reaction. That is the highest tapa, your natural state. You are. Now you know what, so now. Now we can start. So it's not something to keep silent or quiet or something, it's just being that what is action without any reaction, because that is your nature. You are the action. And you don't react to your action. You are always action, 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 action. And there's no second one who is reacting to that. What is that? So there's only action. So when you're awake, aware, there's action. And then there's action, and action, and action, and action.
But where does the reaction come from?
There's no reaction. It's an idea, it's an illusion. Because the illusion is that this is the action and the next moment is a reaction to this moment. No, this moment is infinite and there is no reaction to this moment. The eternal now has no reaction, it's just action, 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 action. There's no reaction, because if there would be a reaction, it would be true. There would be something what is acting and something what is reacting. No, there's only action. So there's no consequence of it. There's no right or wrong reaction, because if all everything is action,
action.
Action, please. That's like a movie. Action. It's not loud. Reaction now. No, action. And then it plays by itself, because the actor is good. He even plays so good that he forgets that he is just playing. That is you now. You play the role perfectly because there is action and you forgot that it's only the role you play. It's not what you are. So what to do? Like Shiva became a Jiva, now believing is a puppet. Now he behaves like a puppet, and he believes in the puppet. And I sit here to remind him, you play a role, that's all. You experience yourself as a puppet, but it doesn't make you a puppet. That's all. So I don't deny the experience, but I deny the consequence. So playing this role, whatever role, has no consequence. You can play the most stupid guy and the most intellect guy, and the most awakened and the most unawakened one. The unawakened experience doesn't make you unawakened, and the awakened one doesn't make you awakened. Both is just action. Good. Questions about that? Coffee. Action. So I always start in the first 5 minutes to cut everything down, then one can go home. But, I always try that if after 5 minutes everyone is done, but then no one goes home with me because everyone feels not bad. Then they want to stay forever, I think.
I'll pay for the full 2 hours.
Only him, he's always going. He's a souffleuse. It's like a souffleuse, it was drinking too much. Souffleuse. Whatever. Good. Uzbekistan, what did you ask? What happened in Paris? Nothing. Nothing happened in Paris. Action. Action has happened in Paris. Action. Like in a volcano, or like an earthquake. It's all action. But life has no consequence for life. And there's even no consequence for this phantom world. Because for 100 to die, 100,000 are born at the same time. another puppet popping up. From that point of view, from the relative human, personal one, oh, what a disaster. I deny that, don't deny that, but actually everyone inside knows already nothing happened. So everyone is already, okay, something new, no, okay, but let's see what happens tomorrow. Maybe 1,000? Everyone is looking forward to something bigger. Maybe more fun, more excitement, and then you can talk even, oh, it's very bad. Oh, it's not so bad. Oh.
Good. So is there any cause and effect?
What did I say the last 5 minutes?
I'm just bringing.
You are not really, you are just making me a most stupid guy ever. Or you. Now the question is, who is more stupid here? Me talking to you or you having the question?
That's the effect.
That is the effect, I better be quiet. Cause and effect. Now, what did I say the whole time, right? There's only action and no reaction, so there's no cause and no effect. But now you ask, what's the cause and what's the effect? Those are two different words. Cause effect is different than action reaction. So maybe there's no action reaction, but there is maybe cause and effect.
What happens? I know it's stupid, but you hit a billiard ball and it starts rolling, right?
Then both energies, the energy of that ball who hits, is just acting as a ball who is moving them. There is no two.
Yeah.
The energy of one ball is the energy of the other ball.
Yes,
so the energy is action and there is an action of that energy.
Yeah.
There is no reaction of energy because there are no two energies. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now you know. What you do with it? Nothing.
Nothing at all.
But that's a good thing about it because you cannot use it in your daily life. Because you're here to hear some recipes how to control your daily life and I don't give you one. Because there is not your daily life anyway, because that would be the reaction of ancestors who created your bloody body, and now you're the reaction of all Adam and Eve events. And then you blame Adam that he was biting into the apple, and I'm the reaction of that action. Me, poor me, because I'm only the reaction of all the events before. Oh, poor me, I have to react to all that bullshit what happened before me. That self-pity then can really has a profound base, if I'm the reaction of some stupid action before. But if there's only action, there is no pity anymore. The pity can only be in reaction. And I'm the poor guy who is just a sperm egg tra-la-la out of my parents, and I'm the reaction of all fucking before. Now I feel so fucked. I feel so fucked up because I'm the reaction of all the fucking before.
What does Ramesh mean when he talks about the programming?
But you have to ask Ramesh. I'm not the interpreter of Ramesh. I really give a fuck about Ramesh teachings, I tell you. I give a fuck about the thinking mind, working mind, and reaction art, and blah, 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 and God's will. I could not find God's willing as much as I looked. And without the willing, there is no will. Will you or will you not?
God's will. I see, I'm not going to get a serious answer from you.
This is the most serious answer, I tell you. Laughing it to death. What did Ramesh mean? When he made his left eye like this and the right eye like this, same question. Why did he look like this and not like this? Why did he say this or this not? Please tell me. You must know. Ramesh was a guy who thought the absolute cannot be reached anyway, so I maybe help people in the daily life. And his teaching was very good in daily life. You could, because there are results of it. But for me, it's a counterproductive thing, for sure. Because you become a sucker for success. And I'm not go for that. And I'm not here to create suckers for success. Because you cannot imply my what I say into your daily life. Because for me, there is no such thing as daily life. So what you can make work in your daily life is counterproductive for what I talk about. That's what I like, that he doesn't remember even what this guy taught him. And he would, if he would be the right one, he would love it. That you
forgot. Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. You're right.
See? In that sense, I know him by heart, and I don't have to read this very book. It's not from him anyway.
No.
Well, that's what I mean. It's not there. It's a name on it, but he is for sure not in it. Because it's like that master's words. Everything what can be black on white is dead anyway. Dead words, even if they're on black and white. Just the paper cannot resist the ink, that's all. If the paper... That is like what you are, like you are the screen and you cannot avoid that someone writes on you. But as an effect, do you care? Yet in the school offices, it was like you can write and then everything was gone. Write again, everything is gone. So every night you should just make and wake up fresh and as a baby. But that is hard. How to then function in daily life, because you're so afraid that you cannot function anymore in daily life, because you still believe that you have done something before, that it was your functioning and you are controlling. And if I tell you there was never such thing as you controlling your daily life, there's all action of consciousness and there is an automatic action without any driver. This car drives by itself. But you're so fucking afraid that it drives by itself that you'd rather die before you admit that you are not the driver.
So, I mean, you're impressions or imprints, things that you hear or experience that makes an impression.
Impact
or impression rather than impact. What, things that...
Yeah, that sounds good, because you are so afraid that you need some story that you keep your back door closed and keep all the storage of your events inside out of fear. That's why it makes an impact. If you just, the fearlessness would just be an open back door, it would just But this little fear, this is existential fear, makes you a collector of shit. And then the shit makes you, you're impressed by shit. You're very impressed by the shit happenings, by your so-called personal story. It's a shit story.
How about if it's a good story?
There are no good stories. Whatever has a story, it cannot be good. Whatever has a story, it has a beginning and end, is relative and can be for sure is not good. And only shit has a story. So shit happens, but what you are never happens. So what to do? So the shit is impressed by shit. This shitty bastard today was very impressed by a shitty experience. And he felt very like a toilet. No, I'm like a toilet. I allow everyone to sit on me because I cannot have it anyway. Even Carl's can sit on me. I just tried to kick Carl out of the toilet I am, out of the 0-0 I am. I tried, as everyone, kicking this Carl out, because Carl is always like a... not needed, but it's still there. You cannot get rid of that thing, so you want to get rid, but there's just a... you just resign. You fail totally of kicking him out. As much as you try, it always pops up again, because the phantom you cannot kill, so what to do? How can you get rid of an illusion? It's only real because you try to get rid of it. Yeah, what can you do? So then you rest in... when you wake up, the presence of a phantom is anyway, and when you're... then it's gone anyway. So it has a beginning and end, so one day it will be gone, so it's a goon already, so it's not even out there. This story already ended, this body is already like a tombstone walking in a cemetery of fleeting shadows. And they cannot make me more or less as I am anyway. But as I'm a toilet, a 0-0, I cannot help it, because they always every day someone sits on you. So you're possessed, but by that possessed, you're not possessed. You have an experience of being possessed by a spirit or something, but it came and it will be gone. No, I don't deny that. It's an experience that you cannot get. Every morning this wakes up. And then the whole day you fight to get rid of it. And then you're so exhausted at night that you just drop. And then next morning, tomorrow maybe, I make it. Then again, and then when you die, this body goes and something else happens. You don't know what happens, but the next will happen. Maybe it's worse or not, or better, but the question is, who cares what comes? There will always be something what comes next. It will never stop. The action never stops. So there was no beginning of the action, there will be no end of it. So what is there to do? Action. Bang and boom. Yeah. It's like when he's coughing, he will ask himself, what have I done wrong the last days that I now have this thought? It's like, how could next time can I prevent myself to have it? That is like this function again. It's like a survival system. How can I learn out of what I have done, what I have not done, and what next I will not do, but maybe I prepare myself for something what will happen anyway, but at least I'm prepared. And I can sit here, you will fail again. If you don't have a cold, your next has a cold, but what's the difference if you have a cold or someone else has a cold? The cold will be there, in the coffin. It's like one who believes to be awakened. What's about then his the people he talks to? There will always be an unawakened one, because there's one who is awakened. And he confirms all the unawakened ones. Because he believes in awakening, they believe in being unawakened, and then there's like a co-dependency of two. There's only one because the other one is. So good. Or so bad. Getting dark. Whoa. Not only inside twilight, outside twilight too.
What?
Twilight outside too. Good. So
no different points.
Do what?
No different points.
Different?
Different points.
Reference point.
Yes.
No. I ask you to have the absolute reference point. You are the absolute reference. Not having a reference point is impossible. Because you're trying now, not having a reference point is just another reference point. That one who is non-identified is still identified by being non-identified. There's no way out, you just try. But the absolute reference point is that what you are. You are that. By just being what you are the absolute reference to everything. So I am the reference. My name already put me into that position. I was there. Whatever.
Yeah. So there's point on the space. Rent, Carlos, whoever here.
They're just
points are referring in the
space.
There
are no reference point in that. They're just different camera positions where the perception perceives itself by.
The camera perceives.
The absolute eye of God. The perception, the absolute dreamer, dreaming himself from different angles, from different camera points. There are no reference points. The reference point is already perceived.
Okay.
There is no perceiver who is perceiving from a special reference point.
But you cannot avoid to talk. You know where you are sitting.
No, I don't know where I'm sitting. You think I'm talking out, you think I'm talking out of one who is sitting?
But you know that the chair is there.
Does the chair know that I'm there? As I'm like a chair, I don't know even what I am and what I'm not. So where do I talk from? Where do you listen from?
Yeah.
Try to find the reference point of the listener. You cannot find it. You go deeper and deeper and deeper get into the ether. You go back. But there's an infinite. Whatever, you can get back. You will never find the end of that, what is the absolute.